In this video, I'm going to show you how I made a render of a real place in Blender using only one picture. Before starting, obviously I need a reference image. So I headed to Pinterest and after browsing for a bit, I found the image that I thought would be fun to create. So without wasting any more time, let's go ahead and start the project. Before we go into 3D, I have to align Blender's virtual camera with the camera that the picture was taken with.
What?
Don't worry, it's easier than you think. To do this, I'm going to be using software called FSpy. If you haven't heard of the software before, don't worry. Everything is very straightforward and simple. All you have to do is drag in your photo and align the points to match the straight lines in your image. FSpy is free, so if you don't already have it, I will leave the link to the download page in the description. Now all that's left to do is save the file and we can move to 3D. In Blender, the first thing I do is import the FSpy data. Now that the virtual camera matches the photo's camera, this means we can begin blocking out the scene. While doing this, make sure that you're not just blocking out from the camera's perspective, because it can cause the blockout to not line up correctly. To avoid this, make sure your blockout makes sense in 3D space. To make the stairs, I used an array modifier so I wouldn't have to duplicate the mesh over and over again. Also, this gives me much more control because I can edit the mesh without having to worry about moving the objects around. Also, I imported a low poly human model for size and proportion reference. Once the rough blockout was complete, I started making the round ornaments on the ground. To do this, I made the basic shape of a tile, then I added an empty in the middle of where I wanted my tiles to be turning around. Then I added an array modifier, changed the array settings to object offset, and set the object to the empty. Now, when you increase the count in the array settings and rotate the empty, the tiles will form a circle. I did this for each row of the tiles. Recently, I got the real-time material add-on for Blender. Even though it's not great for extremely realistic renders, I would still recommend this add-on for quick previs purposes. Because with a click of a button you get a decent material. I used the add-on for all the materials for the objects but later replaced them. In Photoshop I created custom textures for the screen and the cube on the station. Then I started matching the lights. I used a mix of HDRI lighting with low strength and area lamps. For the truck in the back, I used the transportation add-on. I believe this add-on is a must-have because it has a library of very high-quality car assets. After this, I started changing the textures. The textures that looked the best were oddly the easiest to make, and all I did was find a concrete texture, plug it into the base color, roughness, and normal inputs, and tweak the settings a little. The realism that you get is absolutely insane, and you can also add some color variation by adding another concrete texture and then mixing it with the other one. So now, it was a matter of tweaking the scene until you're satisfied with the result. Little changes go a long way. Now, it was time for post-processing. In the color management settings, I changed the look to high contrast and went to the compositor to add glare, blur, and lens distortion. These things make the render look more like a photo from a camera than just a render. Then I went into Premiere Pro and did some color correction and added some vignetting. And that's it! After a lot of tweaks, I ended up with something like this. This is the render compared to the photo. If you liked the video or learned something new, please consider subscribing and liking the video. A simple click of a button goes a long way to support the channel. Thanks and bye.